I'm working with wood veneer, and the veneer is something that I've actually been using probably for close to 20 years. I started working with it because it's a material that starts out as a tree. It goes through this industrial process of being shaved. It's used in industry here, and after I started using it for a while, it's a very expensive material. I started contacting woodworking companies in the area and asking them for their scrap materials, and some places actually did let me come in and take away vast quantities of scrap materials that I've been using up until this piece. I'm taking what was once an organic material, put it through an industrial process, becomes an industrial waste material, and then I'm putting it back into giving it another generation of organic life. And that process, to me, is a process that I see mirrored in nature all of the time, where a tree grows, it dies, it decays, and then it becomes the sustenance for the next generation of life. I see that process of regeneration, recycling, regeneration, as kind of embodying what has happened before into the present, and that will then become a part of the past. I'm taking layers, about 6 to 8 layers at a time, layers of the veneer, and I'm gluing them together, and then I'm clamping them over these forms that I'm building that have different diameters depending upon what kind of curve that I want. And so I'm clamping those down, and then it's almost as though I'm making a very thin plywood of my own shape. Over the last 5 years, I've been interested in kind of making the shift towards from doing work that is just evolves in my studio to doing work that winds up living in a public space. I'm interested in interacting with a particular environment and for a particular kind of maybe audience or function. This opportunity to work at Northeastern came up. They were interested in a visiting artist who would actually be doing some work on site rather than having a show and giving a lecture about the work, so that the visiting artist would be kind of accessible to students, and students could also see what that work process was about. You can see in the maquette that I've got a lot of kind of much looser line in there, and that I think is what gives the form its energy and fluidity, and that kind of thing will have to be developed once I get to the gallery at Northeastern. Although I do think that with Photoshop, we now have the ability to communicate ideas a lot better than maybe a drawing might. And actually putting the maquette into Photoshop and photoshopping it into the space of the library actually helped me understand what the piece was going to be about as well.